गुड मॉर्निंग एवरी वन. सो इन द लास्ट सेशन वी हैव कम्प्लीटेड आवर फर्स्ट चैप्टर ऑफ हिस्ट्री, दैट इज एन इंट्रोडक्शन टू हिस्ट्री. वी हैव डन द एक्सप्लेनेशन, वी हैव डन द क्वेश्चन आंसर ऑल्सो. आई होप दैट इज ऑल क्लियर विद एवरी वन. एवरी वन हैज अंडरस्टूड इट ऑल. नाउ कमिंग टू द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक, बट बिफोर दैट द चैप्टर नेम वी आर गोइंग चैप्टर नेम which we are going to start is understanding diversity. Understanding diversity is directly related to understanding about India. To understand everything about India, to understand India, you need to understand diversity. Okay? India is your country, so you need to know about a lot of things about your country. And to understand about your country, to know things about your country, the very most important thing you need to understand is diversity. To understand diversity, you need to know what is diversity. So let's start. Meaning of the diversity. Diversity means the state of being diverse. We see different types of people in our surroundings. Diversity, in basic term, if I will tell you what is diversity, it means variety. Variety means different options when you have. Like you see different types of people around yourself. So that means you see a variety of people around yourself. You see different types of people around yourself. So that is diversity. They are in different dresses. Example, some wear dhoti kurta, while some other wear kurta pajamas, etc. Some might wear salwar suit, some wear sarees, some ladies wear sarees, and some might do that, cover their face with the dupatta, like ghoongat they do, and different kinds of things, different types of clothes they wear. They speak different languages, Hindi, Urdu, Bengali, Marathi, Punjabi, etc. They follow different religion like Hinduism, Islam, Christianity, etc. So, you see a lot of different things around yourself, which means a different kind of people, different. If there are different kinds of people, means there must be something different in them. And what are that different things in them is? They speak different languages, they eat different kind of foods, they wear different kind of clothes, they have different kind of festivals to celebrate, they follow different kind of religions. For example, if I talk about India, you know, India is a diverse country. India is full of diversity, which means India has a different kinds of different things. Like it has a variety of all the things. Suppose that India's political division is what? 28 states and 8 union territories. 28 states. And you know, all these states has their own culture or kind of dresses, foods, famous foods, and also their famous festivals. So what it means that different states, different people. And all these different peoples eat different kind of foods. They have some speciality in their foods. For example, when you go to the Rajasthan, their speciality is dal bati churma. But if you go towards that South Indians, like if you go towards Kerala and Tamil Nadu, what they eat, idli, dosa, sambar, this is their main food. Okay. Whereas if you go towards north side in the Punjab, what is their main food, famous food, speciality? That is makki ki roti sarso ka saag. This is their famous food. So you can you see that there is different states, so they have different kind of their food speciality. The same way they have the different kind of clothes also. Like if I talk about Gujarat, people used to wear ghagra choli. Whereas if I talk about Jammu Kashmir, they used to wear usually the woolen clothes. Okay, and also they used to wear that cap. The boys used to wear that cap, and they wear that long woolen jacket that protects them from the cold also. So which means they have the different clothes also. We have the different food. Even we have the different languages. Like Punjab, in Punjab people usually speak Punjabi. In Maharashtra they used to speak Marathi. In Gujarat people used to speak Gujarati. In Rajasthan they speak their own languages. We have different languages. I'm just telling you some examples only. You can think of many other languages, many other clothes they wear, many other food items that is famous. So with what it means that we have different kinds of people around ourselves. We have different kind of food around ourselves, different clothes to wear, different languages they speak. So what it means? So many variety in everything. Okay. And also religion also they follow. Not everyone is following the single religion, Hinduism or Christianity or Islam or any other religion. No one is following. It's not like that everyone in the India is following the same religion. No, everyone is following their own religion. Since they have the freedom to choose their religion, they can follow any religion. Okay, so we have a different kind of religions also. So diversity is what? It is a range of many people or things that are very different from one another. So when I'm talking about variety, when I'm talking about diversity, means it includes so many people, means it includes range of people that is different from one another. Not just people or the things also that are different from the one another. A range of people or a thing that is different from one another. So diversity is what? In a basic term, if I'll say, it is a variety of things. But if I have to write a definition, what I'll write? That diversity is a range of many people or things that are very different from one another. So India, if I talk about India, India is a diverse country since it has a different states, and in different states we have a different kind of people. Not in the states only, but in every state you go, you see that there are different types of people. They follow different religion, they eat different kind of foods, they wear different kind of clothes. Not everyone is following the same religion, or not everyone eating the same food, or not everyone is speaking the same language. It's not like that. So everyone is following some different things. So that different thing they are following, or that different options we have, is known as diversity. So I hope the meaning of diversity is cleared, and this is the definition that you have to learn for the diversity. Now moving forward, next topic we have to cover is positive aspect of diversity. Before positive aspect, you need to know that is there any negative aspect also. So when I am saying that is there any negative aspect, means when there is so much different people there, so there might be some different opinions. Okay, so in the different opinions, disagreement will be there. But that disagreement or that negative aspect is too less. In fact, this diversity has so much positive effect or positive impact in our life. But how? That we are going to study in this part. Diversity adds to our lives. The various differences that diversity includes actually enrich our lives in many ways. So this diversity adds to our life means it. The so many differences is not just that it makes the difference in our life. In fact, it enriches our life. It means it adds more positivity and more and more things to learn and more things to experience in our life, since we have the different options, different things. Like, just take some of the example, any other example. Like, if I talk about food, we have so many food options to eat. So because of this food option, we are able to experience these food. If there is no options for the food, you will be eating only one single food all the time. So you don't even know that what it feels like to taste some different kind of food. Okay. The same way, there are so many things, so many different things, so much diversity, that enriches our life. So we can be friends with people who are very different from us. This can enrich our quality of life. We can eat a variety of foods that are different from the food that we normally eat, which means when you make people of who are different from us, like suppose if I am Punjabi, I make a South Indian friend, okay? So what will happen? I used to eat that parathas and the makki ki roti and sarso ka saag. But what South Indian used to eat? They used to eat idli, sambar, vada, these kind of things they used to eat. So what will happen if I make a friend like this, a South Indian friend? So I'll get to taste all these foods which I normally don't eat. Because being a Punjabi, at my home, we don't make this food. We don't usually make idli sambar, dosa sambar, or this kind of food, the South Indian food. So if I make a friend who is a South Indian or who is different from me, so I'll get to taste these foods. Okay, I'll get to have variety of food. I can eat a variety of foods which I normally might not have. We can enjoy by celebrating different festivals, wearing different clothes and learning different languages. Also, if my friend is a South Indian, I am spending my time with her also. So if I'm spending my time with her, I'll get to know her more. And since I'll become friends with her, so I will celebrate everything with her. Like, I will celebrate my festival, so she will come. And when she will celebrate her festival, I'll go to her place. So what will happen? I am celebrating my festivals also. And I'm also celebrating her festivals, which we don't celebrate. Like, being a Punjabi, I might only celebrate major festivals. We don't celebrate all the festivals, na? We know that there are so many festivals in India. So many festivals people celebrate, but we don't celebrate all the festivals. We celebrate festivals according to our family, which our family celebrates. So when we become friends with the different people, or if I talk about that South Indian girl only, so with her I'll get to know the festivals they used to celebrate. Like, South Indians used to celebrate Pongal, Onam. These are some of the festivals they celebrate. But in the North India, we don't celebrate these festivals with that much joy or that much enthusiasm. Okay. And also, I'll enjoy celebrating different festivals with her. And also, while celebrating different festivals, I'll get to know about their clothes also that they used to wear for their specific festivals. Like, since Punjabis wear Patiala suit means Patiala salwar and kameez, whereas the South Indians used to wear dhoti and sari. So I'll get to know about their different kinds of clothes also. I'll try that clothes. I'll try to learn their language also. Maybe I'm not able to learn that perfectly, but I'll try. So what will have, this will add some excitement in my life. This will add some happiness in my life that I am trying something different. And when, why we need to try something different? Because if we will doing the same thing daily, it will become a monotonous life. Means a very boring life. So we need these kinds of things. When, suppose every day if you are eating that same vegetable, will you be able to eat the same vegetable for the 1 month? Like, you are only eating the potatoes for the 1 month. Will you able to do that? No. Since we need variety in the food, the daily, 3 times we eat a meal, so in the 3 times we eat these different vegetables. The same way in our whole life also, we need some different routine. Like we need a Sunday, that is a holiday, we celebrate festivals, so that we can have a different life also other than our daily routine, like going to the school, studying and coming back and again going to the school and doing the same thing. Okay, so this gives some excitement, this gives us chance to learn different things, to try different things. Now, next, diversity enriches our knowledge. When we read a good story, even in other languages, we feel happy because it gives us a lot of ideas. It's not like that we study everything in our language only. Sometimes we study or we read some book or some story in other languages also. And when that story is good, when that story gives us some good ideas, so we feel happy. So it means that diversity also enriches our knowledge. It's not like that we should be limited to our language only to get knowledge. That if I can speak English only or I can speak Hindi only, so I will be restricted to that. I will not try or I will not move towards any other language. They might give us more knowledge. We can get knowledge from the other languages also. So diversity also enriches our knowledge. Diversity enriches our knowledge. The authors also get a lot of ideas from the diversity to write stories or books. They get ideas from the different books and real life situations. They imagine on the basis of the available facts. For example, the Gita Govinda was written by the Jayadeva in Sanskrit language, but it is used even today by the dancers of different dance forms throughout the country. So it means that diversity helps also to get ideas, like authors get ideas while reading the or referring to the other language books, okay, or other cultural books. They will refer to those books, they will get the stories, they will, by reading one or two ideas, by reading the one or two ideas, what happens, it helps you to get more ideas. When you are reading one or two books, or suppose when you are, even now, if you are understanding, you are watching this video carefully, your brain will work and you will get questions also, you will have doubts also, because you are trying to understand the concept. When you are trying to do something, you get more ideas. When your brain starts working, when you actually listen to something, when you actually read something, so you get more ideas. So by reading other language books or referring to the other language or cultures books, you get more ideas, and that ideas, from those ideas, you can, those authors write their own books also. Like the example is also given, this Gita Govinda was written by the Jayadev in Sanskrit, but it doesn't mean that it was written in the Sanskrit, so people who know Hindi or English, they won't refer to this book. They get, even today's, the dancers get ideas from this book, not just in India but throughout the country. Okay, then we read and write different kinds of stories or books. They may relate to real accounts of various kings and queens, stories about love and honor, forest fights, and friendship between people and animals. It would not be possible for the storytellers and writers to write such stories or books by living in one place. So what it means that the storytellers, the people who write these stories, if they have to write, so suppose a person who is a South Indian person, an author who is a South Indian, he writes the story books. But that doesn't mean that he will write the stories only related to the South Indian people. No, he will write the stories related to anyone, any kind of the king or queen, any kind of the love stories, forest, or anything he will write. So this means this diversity will help him to write all these things, which means he cannot just stay at his place and he can write all these stories. For this, he needs to move. He cannot just live at one place and he can write such story books. He need to move. He need to check out the stories. For writing any story, you need to know the story first. And to know the story, you need to visit that place. So, which means that helps this diversity helps an author to write the story books, since they cannot just write it by living at one place. Okay, so when we read a different read or write different story books, so understand that they are not written like at one place, which means they are to know these stories, they are moving from one place to another, which means this diversity is helping them to understand the stories, to write these stories. Because it's never like that a person who is writing a story will write about only South Indian people or the Punjabi peoples only. They will consider the more things also. Okay, so that's all for today. We have discussed about the meaning of the diversity and the positive aspects of the diversity. I hope this much is clear with everyone. And also, do check the Snap homework daily. And also, if any doubt, you can ask in the comment section of this video. There is a comment section below the video. You can write your doubt there. So, that's all for today. Thank you and take care.